Okay guys, today we'll learn how to configure a Dlink camera on your home network, which has a router. So I'm assuming you guys have your router ready with Wi-Fi in your home. So first what we will do is we will go to the mydlink.com and check for which product we have. Then we will check at the back of the camera what version, what hardware we have, and we will download the setup wizard. If you don't have, you might have that setup wizard if you bought the CD, but I'll go ahead and download it from here. I have the CS930L, so I just downloaded it here. You can see it's downloaded, and I'll just click on the exe and it's going to display me this first screen which says welcome, and let's just check for upgrade, and then it says I accept. Okay, you will click I accept the terms and the next, and now it will tell you to plug the ethernet cable, just one time setup, and then put the other end of the side of the ethernet cable inside the router. Then we'll put the power adapter at the back of the camera, and then you will see the LED will turn green. It means ethernet is on, and you need to confirm its screen, and then it will try and search the cameras on the network. This orange means it's not registered, and would you like to register it to my Dlink? You check yes, and then you will enter your password. Make sure this password is going to be stored on your camera. You will click next. It will check the password if it's already configured. You check, otherwise it will store it. First time it will store the password. At this point it will tell you you are wired, and I would like to make a wireless connection or using Wi-Fi WPS. This Wi-Fi protected setup, so you can try this also by selecting a wireless network if it's visible. Let's try. If you keep on scanning the wireless network, and you can choose the wireless network from here. Once it is finished scanning the wireless network, if you don't find it, you might have to go with the WPS if only you're looking for a wireless approach. Otherwise, ethernet will work just fine. Okay, so couldn't find mine, so I'll have to go with the second option. Let me try it one more time. Oops, it didn't find mine this time also. So there's another option. I can go with this also, WPS. This WPS setup, you will have to unplug the ethernet cable, and then once you unplug it, you will have to press the button at the back of the camera, which is WPS, for 6 to 7 seconds. It will start flashing blue, it start blinking basically. Then within 1 minute you will go to router and press the WPS button. This is a small button behind the router. If your router most of Dlink routers support WPS, so you'll have the WPS button. Once you click the WPS button, it will start blinking. Third light on the router is for the WPS, this spherical light just blinking. This will be activated when you press the WPS button. Once everything is once this WPS setup is done, the blue light will stabilize, and the front camera light will turn green, and it will save those settings in the camera, and it will restart the network. Once if everything is fine, it will check for the your camera will try to access the internet, your router, and if everything seems to be fine, it will ask you whether you would like to register this camera to your my Dlink count. So you will add this camera on your my Dlink count, and it will be as a cloud camera and it will be accessible everywhere. So we'll just wait for the next step where it will ask for the credentials of your my Dlink account. If you don't have an account with my Dlink and you would like to create a new one, there is an option where second option which it says create a new Dlink account. So you can choose that one also. That way it will create a new Dlink account and add this camera to your Dlink account. Or if you already have an account, you can attach this camera to your that account. I'll show you that thing in the next step. Okay, so it's asking if it has saved the setting in the camera, and is camera able to connect to your router. Is LED green? And yeah, it will be green. So you will say yes, and once you say yes, it will ask you if you would like to see it signing into my Dlink account. And once it signs into the my Dlink account, it will add this camera to the, see it has added this camera to my account, and it will add shortcuts and all those things on your desktop. Yeah, that's it. So once this is done, you will see this camera when you log into mydlink.com, or you will see it in your app also. You need to download the my Dlink app from
now. You can download this app from App Store, which is my Dlink Lite, and you can check in your remote devices. You'll have this camera added, as you can see mine. Okay guys, now some troubleshooting for the setup. It might happen that things might not turn up the way as I have shown in the video, so you might face some issues. If you face some issues, what you can do is it might be possible that your router is not working as a WPS registrar. It might work by default, it works as a enrollee, so you'll have to log into your Dlink router as I'm logging right now. You need to log into 192.168.1.1. Then you need to go to advanced and the WPS setting. Here you need to check that it should be registrar, it shouldn't be enrollee. By default, it's enrollee. So if it's registrar, then only other devices might establish a WPS connection. So once you do this, you need to reboot both router and your camera. For camera, just plug out the cable and then plug it in again. Yeah. Okay. Nothing works out, and you're not able to set up your camera with my Dlink setup. You can directly connect the camera via Ethernet and log into your camera directly, like I'm logging in right now. You need to enter the same username password which you use while setting up Dlink. Okay, now you need to go to your camera IP address, which you can find from your DHCP clients in the router, and then open that IP address, and then from the wireless setup option you can directly enter your wireless name and your password, and then save, and then just reboot it. That way whenever camera will boot up, it will automatically connect to your router. Thanks for watching.